What's up, fast boys and girls? I'm Limcube, and this is the second chapter of my 10-part video guide series about the advanced Breath of the Wild Any% speedrun route. Today, we will be talking about the more advanced and most influential strategies for the newest Any% route, being shield clipping, and bullet time bounces. Make sure to have watched my first video about basics, as the knowledge of that video will be required to perform these glitches. Clipping into shrines with a shield clip allows us to skip the first tower on the Great Plateau in a speedrun. Without the activation of this tower, no shrines will normally be unlocked, but their pedestals are actually active. So to access them, we need to clip into them. Before we take an extensive look at shield clipping, we need to understand what skew is. Link unequipping his shield mid-shield jump, causing him to briefly tilt, is what we refer to as Link having skew. This exact tilt is what pushes you into walls when performing a shield jump, then unequipping your shield mid-air in the right spot facing a wall. You set a skew angle by landing your shield on slopes, which makes the game remember Link's position as he is in the shield surf state. So, the angle of your skew depends on the angle you shield surf in. And yeah, this all sounds very complicated, but let's look at the Stasis Shrine, which is actually the first shrine in the Any% route. This is what we'll use to learn how to set skew and then shield clip. Now, keep in mind, the setups to clip into shrines are different depending on the shrine. So, you'll be setting skew and then set up the clip differently for all of them. When you come up to the Stasis Shrine in the speedrun, and for the setup I use, you need to be on a fresh file before activating the Great Plateau Tower. You want to shield jump and then hit the shrine wall at around this area. Landing your shield like this should set your skew angle to be able to clip into the shrine. And if you hear some sort of clonk sound like this, it's actually always a good sign that you have skew. To confirm that you did everything correctly so far, do a shield jump and then unequip your shield mid-air. You should see Link tilting. If that's not happening, you actually need to redo the setup until you have skew. Now that you have the right skew angle, you can actually clip through the wall. The setup I use is from a top runner called Razen Runs, and that's what I will teach you. But make sure to check out different top runners if you don't like this one. The first thing you want to do is face the shrine wall here while holding the target button on your controller so Link pulls out his shield. Look at Link's feet. His left foot needs to be aligned with this specific black spot on the floor. And this is all you need to do to set up Link's position. Next, we need to set up his angle. To do that, press and hold the throw button, which leaves Link's position static but allows you to change his angle. You want to focus on the minimap in the right corner of the screen and look at the field of view lines that are displayed on there. To set up Link's angle, the left of the two field of view lines should just be on the right of the orange dot here that signals you where the game wants you to go, the Great Plateau Tower. Now that you have skew and set your angle accordingly, we are finally ready to perform the clip. To do that, you need to shield jump, and just as you are in this vertical position, unequip your shield. Link's skew will cause him to clip through the wall. Now if you do not clip, you either don't have skew, so make sure to check as described earlier, or you don't have the right skew angle, so reset up your skew. To be able to do that, you need to remove your flawed skew angle. Doing a grounded shield jump like this will allow you to do that. Once you land, your skew angle is gone and you are free to perform a resetup. There's actually a little trick that you can do here that will help you practice and will actually even help you in runs when you really need to care about your shield durability. If you unequip your shield first, then continue the game for just a fraction of a second and then re-equip your shield immediately, landing will actually not cause any shield damage. This strategy can also be done when setting skew initially to avoid losing durability, and when you get a lot of misses you can get scared that your shield will break. Because keep in mind, when you actually want to do speedruns of this game, your shield needs to stay healthy. Without a shield, you cannot clip, and without clipping, you cannot complete the Great Plateau. Well, at least you can complete it fast. The last thing that could happen during this shield clip is that you actually have the right skew angle, but still it seems like you can clip through the wall. This is probably because you are not set up correctly in terms of Link's angle and Link's position. So you can redo the clip attempts as much as you want until you bonk. Bonking is this animation. This will remove your skew, so if this happens to you, you need to redo the skew setup. Now let's look at the world where you've done it. You actually successfully clipped through the wall. All you need to do now to enter the shrine is crouch under the platform here and then stand up and jump in. In the next tutorial for this first segment of the speedrun, I will show you a faster way to get in. Okay guys, this was a lot. But if you successfully made it into this shrine without going to the front door, you have completed one of the most complicated tricks in the run. I know how complicated this is, but don't get discouraged. Later on, this clip will be very easy and natural to do for you. The Bullet Time Bounce, or for short BTB, allows us to travel at insanely high speeds through the air. You will in fact be traveling so fast that the overworld will sometimes freeze in order for the game to load. It can be performed using various frozen enemies or even Cryonis blocks, but in the Any% route, we just use normal Red Bokoblins to perform them. To do a bullet time bounce, you need a shield, a bow, and arrows. The main mechanic here is that you need to land on your target's head with a shield jump while being in bullet time, as the name of the trick suggests. Make your way to this platform here at the Great Plateau. Later on, we will use this platform to perform a bullet time bounce setup to travel to the bomb shrine. For now, it is my goal to teach you guys any bullet time bounce. It doesn't matter which angle it is, it doesn't matter how fast you go, and this one specifically is a nice spot to just get any bullet time bounce regardless of angle, regardless of speed. First, you want the Bokoblins to notice you. You can do that by whistling as you climb up to the platform and then move slightly back as you stand on it. Now wait until one of the Bokoblins walks up to you. Targeting that Bokoblin will help you for the next steps of the trick. If he is close to you, you want to jump and then mid-air shield jump in a way that you are positioned above the Bokoblin. As you are in the air above the Bokoblin during your shield jump, pull out your bow to activate the bullet time mode. If you hit the Bokoblin's head or back with your shield in that specific mode, you will hear a sound and get a visual effect just like this. When you see that happening, press Y to leave bullet time mode and you will literally fly through the stage. Later in runs, we will be doing very precise setups to get the BTB angles we want, but for now just have fun with it, it will help you to understand the mechanic. In your practice, you can just pull out the paraglider afterwards and fly around a bit, but in speedruns later on when you want to land from a BTB, you need to perform a fall damage cancel as you do not have access to the paraglider yet. I described how to do a fall damage cancel in my first tutorial about basics, so just make sure to check that one out first and learn how to fall damage cancel. An easy way to cancel and then land from a BTB is to unequip your shield to start falling, and then re-equip it to make the fall damage cancel happen. If you made it up until this point, I'm very, very proud of you. These mechanics and these tricks are hard, very complicated to understand, but extremely rewarding to perform. We went through all the basics and advanced basics now, so in my next video we are ready to look at the first segment of the speedrun. Starting in the Shrine of Resurrection and ending as we get our first Spirit Orb, this first segment will be called Stasis and will most likely be the first split on your timer. I know you're super excited to start practicing the actual speedrun, but make sure to practice not only these advanced basics, but even the main basics that I've talked about in my first video a lot. And if you have any questions, ask them either in the comment section below or in the official Breath of the Wild speedrunning Discord, which you should definitely join. I have linked that Discord in the description below. If you do want to see full runs of this game, I'm personally very active on Twitch.tv. I linked my channel in the video description, so make sure to come by and say hi. But for now guys, thank you so much for watching. Keep practicing. Don't get discouraged. This speedrun is hard, but super rewarding to pull off. Make sure to tune into the next tutorial, and let's do this.